Whenever you're about to start some exercise, you always want to think about the outcome. Like, how do I want to leave this workout? How do I want to leave this hour? Or maybe it's 20 minutes or 30 minutes. Do you want to be leaving better, worse, or the same?
Welcome to the Exercise is Health podcast, where we're talking about exercise, health, and the interconnectedness of the two. We are your hosts, Charlie
and Julie,
and we will be coming to you every single week from our studio, Muscle Activation Schaumburg. Hey, welcome back, everybody, to the Exercise is Health podcast. We are your hosts, Charlie
and Julie,
and we're coming to you from our studio, Muscle Activation Schaumburg in Schaumburg, Illinois. Now, at Muscle Activation Schaumburg, we believe your health is your most valuable asset. Your health is one of the biggest influencers of the quality and quantity of time that you have. And while there are many aspects of health, our expertise is exercise. Exercise has been proven time and again to not only improve your health, but also increase your longevity and improve your quality of life. And today, we are answering your questions about exercise. And we had one sent in that we get all the time, especially during this time of year. And the question says, "Hey, Julie and Charlie, I've been listening to your podcast for quite some time and really appreciate all the insight and tips. I've been adding in a lot of what you've been talking about into my workouts, and they are going great. However, with it being the holiday season coming up, I'm concerned that my exercise may not be as consistent as it normally is. What kinds of things do I need to make sure to do during my workouts to help me through this holiday season with my workouts?" So thank you so much for sending in this question, because like I said, during this time of year, this is a question that we get all the time in one variation or another. And I think it's really important to address the very valid concerns that you're bringing up. And so we have four tips for you for things to think about and ways to adjust your workouts during this holiday season to ensure that not only are you still getting your workouts in, but they are helping you build your health and not break your body down.
And before we jump into the tips, I do want to acknowledge that I love this question because, number one, you're telling us that, hey, I want to kind of take charge of this, not just see what happens. A lot of times when people are on a roll with their fitness routine and holidays or vacations or last minute things come up or parties, and then I'm sure you're going to have a lot of parties this season. When these things come up, a lot of times we just go with the flow. We go with the path of least resistance, which is skip the workout, drop off on the nutrition train. And the problem comes when we go with the flow. So use these tips we give you and your mindset to decide that you're not gonna just go with the flow. You're not just gonna go with whatever pops up in your schedule or whatever you feel obligated to do, because your health is so incredibly important, and it's important that it's at least maintained through the holidays. And the second reason why I love this question is because and you know what, Charlie and I saw this the last 2-3 years, is that when do you want to start getting in shape? Everyone always has the New Year's resolution, right? It comes January 1st, and you're like, I'm going to get back to the gym, get back on my routine, and you know, all that stuff. And I love that people are motivated. That's cool. But what we see year after year after year is that because there's been 1 month, 2 months if you count Thanksgiving, 3 months if you count Halloween, of just going with the flow and falling off the routine and not taking care of your health, is that come January, as you start cleaning up your routine and your eating and your exercise, you don't feel very good. I'll have to say the first week of January is the biggest week of cancellations that Charlie and I get, because people don't feel good. They've got migraines and can't figure out why. Their body's achy. They're incredibly tired. They're slammed at work. And so it's just so interesting, because even when your ambition is high, which is at the beginning of the year, a lot of times our bodies that we've been kind of treating not that well for the last 1 to 3 months is now not feeling well enough to do what your mind wants it to do. So during the holidays, use these tips so that you're able to jump back on the train and maintain your health through the holidays, so that you're not having those negative side effects of the holidays.
Absolutely. And it really reminds me of the video that we produced last year, where we candidly asked our clients on camera, why is it important to you to be healthy for the holidays? And so often we assume that during the holidays, our health is just going to be there. But it's like every other time of year, if you want your health to be there, you have to put in effort, you have to work towards it. And with all the other stresses that come along for the holidays, it's actually far more likely that your health isn't there during the holidays, or Julie, like you're saying, it's not there immediately after because your body just finally says, enough, I can't take it anymore. So making sure that you're continuing to exercise during this holiday season is of the utmost importance if you want to maintain your health throughout what can be a very stressful time of year, but should also be a celebratory time when you are with family and you are with loved ones. So if you want to be able to take advantage of that, listen up, because we have four tips of things you need to be doing.
So our first tip is adjust your expectations. A lot of times when we go to the gym or we're working on a fitness routine or we're consistently exercising or eating healthy, we expect that we must see some kind of change, some result, some notable number change on a scale or with a measuring tape, or that you start feeling better or more energized. But oftentimes when it's the holiday season, there are a lot of bad temptations, a lot of new obligations that's not normally in your schedules. And guess what? That is okay. But it's still important to exercise, it's still important to eat well, but we do have to adjust your expectations on what you're getting out of exercise. Exercise and eating healthy and doing all your healthy routines, maybe that's meditating and getting quality sleep and all those things, are still incredibly important, even when you're not seeing pounds come off every week, or you're not seeing your numbers increase at the gym with how much weight you're able to lift, or you're not seeing more definition in your arms and abs as you go through the holiday season. I often talk to my clients about changing your expectation of maintaining through the holidays. Because of all these extra temptations and all these new obligations with parties, etc., family events, it's really important that we think about using your healthy routine to keep your body functioning as well as it can with these changes. So when you're exercising, keep in mind, I'm here to maintain and keep up the quality of my health as much as possible, and kind of drop that mindset of, I'm demanding change from my body right now, and I'm demanding and want to see numbers change, because that's what leads to disappointment. And that's what a lot of times why people will stop exercising during the holiday season, because they're like, well, it's kind of useless if I'm not losing weight this month, or it's kind of useless if I'm not increasing my weights this month. And actually, that's quite wrong. We have to be thinking about, if you don't maintain your body, it's going to decrease, or it's going to decline, or it's going to lose its health, lose its ability to move, lose its ability to be as strong as it was. So keeping up your exercise, but keeping a mindset and an expectation of maintenance rather than an opportunity to really improve and make huge gains during this time.
Hey, Julie, that's such a good point, because oftentimes, like you're saying, when we're thinking about changes that we want to see with exercise, we're thinking, okay, what changes can happen with my body in the next 4 to 6 weeks? And during the next 4 to 6 weeks, this time of year, we want to see things like maintained. We want to make sure that we're not losing anything and that we are able to keep the momentum going that you've been working all year to build. So adjusting your expectations that, okay, during the next 6 weeks, you might not see your body decrease 3 pounds, your body weight decrease 3 pounds. You might not see these tremendous strength gains because there's all this other stuff going on, or if you're a little bit less consistent with your workouts. So first and foremost is, like Julie's saying, hey, make sure you adjust your expectations. And over the next 4 to 6 weeks, if you can just maintain the status of your body with your workouts, that's awesome. That's a win. And then you can head into January, not in a deficit, but rather continuing to build off the momentum that you spent all of 2018 building. The second tip that we want to give you is, again, to prioritize resistance training. And with prioritizing resistance training, making sure that you're doing it a minimum of twice a week. Oftentimes when we feel like we are in some kind of time crunch, like we just don't have enough time to exercise, we default to cardio. And look, going for a run, going for a bike ride, going for a walk, those are all fine and well. But if you want to talk about what you can actually get the most bang for your buck for this holiday season when it comes to working out, resistance training is where it's at. So if you have to set aside a little bit extra time to go in and get a 20 to 30 minute really good resistance training workout, that's what you have to do. And you have to do it at least twice a week, okay? The physiological nature of needing to do resistance training twice a week doesn't change for your body just because it's the holiday season, all right? But you may not want to try to burden yourself with trying to commit to 3 or 4 days a week. So stick to twice a week if you feel comfortable hitting that, no less than that though, and making sure you're getting at least 20 or 30 minutes in order to make sure that your strength stays up, that you know, your bone density stays up, that your muscle function and joint function stay up, and that you maintain some relative level of fitness throughout the holiday season going into 2019.
Now, I have to say, this one is actually my biggest challenge because during the holidays, I love to be with family. And a lot of you guys know I live in Illinois and my family lives in Florida. And so I just don't get to see my family that often. And Charlie and I were actually just in Naples for Thanksgiving. And one of the things that, again, I struggle with is getting in my resistance training while on vacation or while during the holidays. And so what my mom and I did, which here's a cool tip, is I also want to make sure that she is resistance training. What we actually did was during one of our grocery trips, we went to the gym that was right across the street before because we have to drive there anyway. So we drove over to the gym, did 30 minutes of workout, and while we walked in, we told each other we're doing 30 minutes and leaving. At 30 minutes, we are done. We're walking out because we got things to do. We got Thanksgiving to prepare for. So we drove over, went to the gym, 30 minutes. Then we popped right over to the grocery store, which we were going to go to anyways. And it worked out really, really well. And that's what we often find that we're doing, is that we'll pair our gym trip with something else. And of course, we'll do cardio from the house, you know, go for walks and whatever. But that's a quick tip that I like to use that works for me. And I actually did it just this past week while we were in Naples, Florida for Thanksgiving.
Now, the third tip that we want to give is to utilize the fringes of your week and utilize the fringes of your day, meaning utilize your mornings, utilize your weekends, utilize the times when you might not otherwise work out, but they're also less likely to have other social obligations, okay? So get your workouts in the morning if you know that you're going to have holiday parties in the evening. Get your workouts in during the weekends if it seems like during the week there's so many work functions going on. So utilize the times when you know that the holiday parties are not going to be going on, and prioritize getting your workouts in, okay? The time is still there. I have yet to meet one person who from Thanksgiving through New Year's was at a holiday party 24/7, literally the entire holiday season. So you have time when you're not doing the social stuff, and you have to prioritize getting your workouts in during those times. It might feel a little bit crunched, so do the best you can time-wise to get it in, but going and doing a little workout is a heck of a lot better than not doing any kind of workout. So if you can get your workout in the morning, you can get your workout in on the weekends, that will make a tremendous difference over the next 4 weeks or 6 weeks or however long much left we have in the holiday season going into 2019 than just skipping it altogether.
Yeah, I love that tip because it's true. Usually work functions and parties are happening in the evening. And also weekend evenings. So using those morning times and mornings on the weekends can be really helpful. Another thing that I like to address with using your fringes, you know, like Charlie had said, but using your lunch hour. A lot of times, you know, if you can't get into the gym in the morning because you got to get to work, a lot of times people have like an hour lunch. So why don't you pack your lunch for the month of December and try to get in some exercise during your lunch hour, because I know and you know that your other food choices aren't going to be the most healthy. So maybe don't go out to lunch this month and make sure you get in your movement time during your lunch period. I always feel like even if I only have 15, 20 minutes to do some kind of movement versus doing no movement, I always feel better. I always try to get in some full range of motion, resistance training, or if it's a cardio day, I'll do cardio if I have time for that. But it definitely helps with a lot of the inflammation that I feel I get from my poor eating and my less movement that I have during the holidays. And it just really helps me get to that maintenance idea, meaning like, hey, I'm doing things that are kind of wearing my body down. So let me make sure I find time to do exercise, resistance training, cardio, my nutrition, to make sure I'm maintaining and almost building up. So it's almost like that's your kind of your build up time, but you're doing a lot of other stuff that's kind of wearing you down. So it kind of balances out. So try to find those little lulls in time, you know, whether that's your morning or your weekend or your lunch hour. Or a cool one I just heard from my mom this past week is she used to exercise while we were doing our sport activities. So maybe you take your child to their sports in the evening or during the weekends. Can you exercise while your child is doing their sports? I thought that was cool. My mom shared that with me and I didn't know. She's like, yeah, we used to take you to swim practice and I would run while you guys swam. And then I'd be done with my workout for the day and you guys would be done with your sports. So that's another cool one you can play with.
The last tip that we want to give is to understand that exercise is a stress to your body. So you have to adjust your workouts accordingly, okay? Not just adjust them based off the amount of time you have available for them, but adjust them based off how your body's feeling. If you're staying up later, if you're eating foods that you're not normally eating, if emotionally you feel more stressed during the holidays, you have to adjust how you're doing your workouts. Had a client come in this morning and he was up later last night than he normally is. And it was Thanksgiving week, so he had been eating a bunch of food that he doesn't normally eat. And we had to adjust his workout today. We had to go a little bit lighter in some areas. We had to play with the intensity a little bit and not have him work out as hard today as he might otherwise have worked out, because exercise is a stress to the body. And so if you're getting all these other stresses to the body, the foods you're eating, emotional stress, not sleeping well, then adding this physical stress of exercise, if done inappropriately, can be a really negative stimulus for the body. So you have to be mindful of how your body's feeling and make sure that you are stimulating your body appropriately with exercise. And a lot of times during the holidays, that might mean that you need to tone your workouts down.
You know, we actually talk about this even when it's not holiday season, but whenever you start an exercise bout, let's say you arrive at the gym or you just put on your tennis shoes, you're going to go for a jog, or maybe you got your bathing suit on, you're going to do some water aerobics. Whenever you're about to start some exercise, you always want to think about the outcome. Like, how do I want to leave this workout? How do I want to leave this hour? Or maybe it's 20 minutes or 30 minutes. Do you want to be leaving better, worse, or the same? And the two things that we have to consider here is how you're entering your workout and what you're going to do for your workout. And I would advise, as I always do, you should try to leave your workouts feeling better, your body doing better, your body in a better, healthier state. So we want to structure what you do to try to bias, I'm leaving the workout better. And we also want to take time to analyze how you're entering the workout. During the holidays, a lot of times we enter a workout with higher stress levels, even if you're happy, or even if you do feel emotionally stressed. A lot of times when we're overwhelmed with tasks That can be stressful and taxing, even if they're fun and exciting. A lot of times when we enter a workout and we've had a lot to eat, maybe had more cookies than you intended to have, you think, oh, I got to burn these calories off, you know, so I better just, you know, push myself. But we actually have to step back and think, do you feel like your body's better nourished or worse nourished than normal going into a workout? And although you may have excess energy, excess calorie energy is what I mean, we're probably a little less nourished. You're probably not eating as clean as you might have. You might probably not eating as balanced. Maybe you're having more sugar than you're used to. So even though you've had more calories, we have to think, okay, so I've also taxed my body with how I've been eating. So all these factors, including sleep, I'm sure, I mean, at the holidays, I always sleep more poorly because I know I'm having, you know, the foods that I know don't make me feel good. The foods that make me feel a little more swollen. I know it, whenever I'm at the holidays, I'm also walking around way more than I am, like, you know, wrapping gifts and walking here and there and there and there, and then my legs are tired all day, you know, all the things. So we have to take in consideration all these factors when you're entering a workout. So during the holidays, oftentimes all we think about is, oh, I've ate too much, I gotta burn a ton of calories. But the problem when we do that, we leave our workouts worse. Our bodies are more taxed, more stressed, more sore, more achy. Our bodies are less functional. So analyze how you're entering your workout. Choose wisely. And the reason that we always recommend resistance training, especially if you do it the way that Charlie and I talk about, then this will help boost your body. It will help your body be able to function better. So really think about that when you're doing your exercise, especially at the holiday time, because we want you to be using your exercise again to maintain. That means that you're trying to rebuild all the stressors that you're adding to your life. So we have to be leaving the workouts better off than when we started, even if that means you actually physically do less than what you're normally doing, or you're doing less weight or less reps or less exercises, or you're running a less of a distance than normal. So consider, how are you entering the workout? Use that information, like almost do like a self-scan, you know, when you walk into your exercise or you tie on your shoes or whatever, and use that information to make better decisions and think about, what am I going to do? What are my actions going to be during this workout? So that you can bias, because you get to choose really. So you can bias how you're going to leave the workout. So often we get so stuck in, oh, I have to do this pre-structured workout that the video is telling me to do. Or I did 50 pounds before, so now I'm going to do 50 pounds today. We really have to be considering how you're entering the workout so that you can be leaving your workout in a better state so that you can maintain your health through the holidays.
So this holiday season, it is of the utmost importance that you continue to exercise on a regular basis. We are fully aware that there may be more social obligations for you, that it can be an emotionally stressful time of year, that you might be eating foods that you don't normally eat, and your body may not be as well rested as it normally is. So in order to ensure that you're able to continue to get your workouts in, you first and foremost, you have to adjust your expectations and know that during this holiday season, if you can maintain the momentum that you've built during 2018, 2019 is going to be that much better. So adjust your expectations. You don't need to crush it during the holiday season and try to progress a whole bunch, but rather just kind of maintain where you're at. In 2019, you're going to be starting off on the right foot, okay? You need to be incorporating resistance training a minimum of twice a week. Use the fringes of your days and of your weeks in order to get your workouts in. Utilize your morning, utilize your lunch hours, utilize your weekends. Use the times when you know you don't have the added obligations and get your workouts in, even if it's only 20 to 30 minutes. And finally, be able to adjust your workouts on the fly, understanding that exercise in and of itself is a stress to your body, and how your body utilizes that stress, whether it be for building your body or breaking your body down, is largely dependent upon the state that your body is in. So do a self-diagnostic check. See, how's my sleep level? How are my energy levels? Physically overall, how am I feeling? How well nourished am I nutritionally? What is my emotional state? Do I feel particularly stressed? And be able to adjust your workouts accordingly. Remember, the goal over the holiday season, if you can maintain what you've built in 2018, you'll be golden going into 2019. But that's going to require you to be able to adjust your workouts on the fly if you find that the holiday season is a little bit crazier for you, more so than the rest of the year. Well, thank you so much for tuning in. We always appreciate your attention. We appreciate you sending your questions. If you have other questions for us, feel free to email them over to info@matschaumburg.com or connect with us on one of our various social platforms via Instagram or Facebook. And we will be sure to include it in our December episode of the Q&A. Have a fantastic week, and we'll talk with you all next week.